Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's been a while since my last update, and I do have a good reason to do one now. Since not only do we have interesting earthquakes to cover, I also need to talk about new information that might change a bit how we look at the Reykjanes Peninsula and the unrest to come. And since Christmas is coming, we will of course check out Santa Claus, his take on this, and finally, I will reveal some of my plans for the channel in 2023. So you might want to stay till the end. But let's start with the earthquakes on the Reykjanes Peninsula, where things have been unusually quiet since the last eruption came to an end 4 months ago, or until just a few days ago, when you noticed these earthquakes between Grindavík and the Blue Lagoon, or where we got the third magma intrusion early this year. And it's not where we want them, for the simple reason that this is not the kind of Christmas tree that we want near this town. But luckily, this swarm seems to have been fading out. And it was then yesterday when a magnitude 3.4 earthquake was shaking Reykjavík and originated on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And even though it's not very large earthquake, I did some browsing. So let's go back in time. Or just about when my channel was about to take off before the 2021 eruption. And when I started, I knew my limitations quite well, especially when it comes to geology. So first and foremost, I wanted to get the basics right. So I started to do my own maps, where I was showing all the systems on the peninsula, or the main features. So many of my videos have been built on top of this map. And I was always under the impression that after seeing all those articles about the peninsula, that I had this region more and less covered. As for the main features, like I was under the impression that there was no central volcano on the peninsula. That has been the official story for a long time. Or so I thought until yesterday when I came across this article on the Icelandic Science Web. And it's a new article published December 15th. And it was mainly answering a question, how was a lake Kleifarvatn that we see here formed? And that lake is truly one of our mystery spots. It seems to have kind of natural magnetism to it. And it is indeed one of my favorite places on the peninsula. So I actually did a video about it a year ago, also covering the explosion craters that we have around. And one of the questions that I could not answer fully was, how was this lake formed? So I was wondering about if it was an explosion crater. And I have to admit that it bothered me a bit that we had this huge lake there, but nobody seems to know about how it came into being. And there we are into the basis of my channel, because I'm a photographer, only trying to answer how come that this formation looks like it does, and since when. But surprisingly enough, finally, this article told me that the lake might be a part of the eastern rim of a circular caldera 10 kilometers in diameter, and the lake was formed after the land subsided after an eruption, just like Lake Askja that I've been covering recently. And as I started to browse through the sources linked to this article, and this theory seems to be gaining more general acceptance, but it is however a long time since it was first mentioned by a geologist that is no longer amongst us. So to find this at this time point was a surprise, but somehow thinking about it, this lake, that is not as much of a surprise. And let's get into what I've been talking about since before the last eruption, and also the months thereafter. I was talking a lot about this region where this caldera might be, due to all the earthquakes that we have seen there. And those earthquakes were explained as tension changes in the crust, due to the magma intrusion that took place under Mount Keilir, and fed the eruption in 2021 and 2022. So it was this pressure from there, and that answer worked for me for a while, or until like 2 months after the eruption came to an end. The dike was turning cold and there were no earthquakes around it, but I did see earthquakes line up between Mount Keilir and this new area that we are looking at. So it occurred to me if the magma intrusion simply found a new way to the east this time, and it's not for me to say. I'm just speculating because that's one of the fun parts about geology. It leaves plenty of space for such thoughts. because we only know so much. And the news about this new caldera, it got me all fired up. Especially because it was coming from reliable sources or the university. And if it is indeed an old caldera, it is located on the most active part, on the fissure swarm, on the Krýsuvík volcanic system. And it is a system that stretches all the way into Reykjavík. So it's not a system that we want to wake up. We don't need that. However, there is no clear topographic expression on the surface that indicates a central volcano. No magma reservoir seems to be present in Krýsuvík. Only those indications that Krýsuvík is indeed hosting a buried caldera and intrusion complex by its roots. And it tells us that it is a huge task for our experts to cover all this huge island of ours. Nothing but volcanoes. And let's hope that Santa Claus gives them some gadgets to poke into the ground and see what they come up with. And speaking of Santa, I gave it a thought to do like I did last year, or to ask Santa himself to do his own prediction. He is older than many of our volcanoes. And it so happens that Santa has a workshop nearby. We are in the north, after all. And it was very easy for me back then to get an interview where Santa shared his ancient wisdom to look into the future, or a special treat for my subscribers. And looking back at his prediction a year later, we can say with scientific wisdom that Santa has no wisdom at all when it comes to geology. His predictions were all wrong, and we might just as well ask Rudolf the reindeer to do an earthquake prediction. And since I'm mentioning Rudolf, it's him to blame that Santa didn't want to give me the drone that I wanted for Christmas. A drone with a thermal camera. And it costs less than $7,000. US. Santa told me that he's done with drones after this incident with Rudolf that hit a drone while flying over Austria. And the blades cut one of his ears off. And Santa told me personally that there is no way that he is going to give away this flying stuff again. Ever again. And I hope that explains something for you out there. And your kids. But to do something for me, he gave me this Christmas sweater. And today, Rudolf is only doing the rural areas where there are no drones. He's still a bit nervous. And the elves provided Santa with Rudolf the Skoda, mostly to do the cities and towns. And Santa told me that he doesn't like Skoda. He asked for a Chevy with a big block engine. So the same goes for him as the rest of us. We just can't have it all. However, it doesn't change my plans for the next year. And like you've often seen, my most important tool is a drone. Not just to get closer, but also to get the wider picture. Especially when it comes to volcanoes. The drone that I was trying to get from Santa had a thermal camera that could work miracles for my channel. I would even see Rudolf the reindeer through the thermal camera, so it's no need to worry about him. And I have to mention also that a year ago, when the magma intrusion took place by Grindavík, thermal camera drone is a tool I would have liked to have back then, or to fly around there every 6 hours and see if there were any changes on the surface. And of course, fly over the older lava fields. See how they cool down. But my channel is still young and my YouTube income this year didn't even pay my petrol bill. But I am fine with it. And the plan now is to finish to process all footage from last year so I can finally make a decent portfolio for myself. And from there I might go into crowdfunding to get this tool that might be a total game changer for my channel. More range, super zoom, and it's a tool that I can use when it's minus 20 degrees Celsius outside, rain or snow. And we know that there are at least 2 volcanoes getting ready now, and both of them are out of range for me today. So you know where I'm heading with my channel. It might not be the perfect business model for me yet. I'm still losing money on this, but I don't care. I'm up to 35,000 subscribers. It's one of the 10 largest YouTube channels in Iceland, and I know that I'm on the right way. And my belief is that a professional grade drone will give me the opportunity to get the income I need from the Icelandic market to make everything click. so I can work on my videos for YouTube, but be on a safe side when it comes to income, and share the travel cost when it comes to projects where I have to drive hundreds of kilometers, like my volcano trips. So I am serious about this. And my main project now in December has been to sort out some of the footage that I was shooting last summer, some terabytes. I look forward to show you some of it. Like my Christmas video will be about Snæfellsjökull Glacier, perhaps the most mystical volcano in Iceland, in beautiful surroundings. And that video will be online shortly. I might do another earthquake and volcano video soon, since I didn't cover all the earthquakes now. There is more going on. So let's just see what Mother Nature will do the last days of the year. It's not over yet. And the Christmas message from Iceland now is, don't be stressed. Relaxed house is better than not perfectly cleaned house. So we have to give ourselves some slack there. And if you are in Iceland, if you are one of the Christmas tourists, take my advice and don't try the traditional pissfish. You will regret it, and you will regret it even more. If you watch my most unpopular video so far about the truth, how it's made, coming straight from a guy who used to work in a fish factory for many years. So there is no tourist decoration there, and I'm linking to this video. This channel has always been and will always be about Iceland as is. And with that, I'm sending you season greetings from snowy Iceland with a little sample of Christmas lights. Since the days are so extremely short here and we just use every chance we get to stay in the light and have plenty of them around. And finally, Merry Christmas in Icelandic sounds like this. Gleðileg jól.